Hey everybody, welcome back. This is Revolution once again, and the last episode of TMS Sharp FE. We had lessons with Barry Goodman and pretty much talked for the entire episode. But this time we're actually going to be doing something productive and go to a dungeon. Once we go see the concert, and all you see is just colored silhouettes of people, and here's Tsubasa. You talk to her to even initiate the event. Hi, Itsuki. The concert's about to start. Then let's go. Wow, everyone's really excited. It's a live concert featuring both Kiria and Yashiro Tsurugi. Of course they're excited. Again, I'm not very sure if I'm pronouncing Yashiro's name right. Right, Kiria mentioned him. Is he really that amazing? A live concert this big? Yatsufusa Hatanaka? It's probably the only guy who could set up something like this. Yatsufusa Hatanaka? Guys, it's about to start. Wow, Kiria's so amazing. She's so cool. Whoa, I can see why you're recommending her all that time. See? Just by singing, just by standing on stage, Kiria can give people energy. Tsubasa? Are you okay? I want my singing to give people that energy too. I want to be able to shine on stage, just like Kiria. Tsubasa. I've made up my mind. I'm gonna do it, Itsuki. So never mind all that stuff I said before. Before? When I saw I wasn't cut out to be an idol like my sister. Just watch. I'm going to be an idol, no matter what it takes. I may not be as good as Kiria, but I promise I'll sing so I can give people... Well, it'll show up for me. There we go. I'll sing so I can give people energy and make my fans happy. It's not going to be easy. Yeah, I know. But I'm not going to let that stop me. I'll be right behind you. I don't know what else I can do, but I promise I'll do anything I can to help. If you're cheering for me, I feel like I can do anything. Magical anime girl, activate! That scene honestly reminds me of all those anime cliches. Tsubasa Urobe's soul as an entertainer has achieved a new awakening. Fire Emblem reference. Or joke, I don't know. Tsubasa's inspiration has taken form as new performer, Wings of Song. What is this? It came from within me. Former is shining before Tsubasa's eyes. Looks like you managed to find the answer all on your own, Tsubasa. Miss Maiko? What you're feeling right now is the message Kiria wanted to convey through her performance. And that performer is proof that you found the inspiration for your own answer, Tsubasa. You just opened up a door within you to a new gift. A gift? Now then, next up would be Yashiro's... They've ripped a hole in space-time! Quick, someone call the doctor! I don't even like Doctor Who, I don't know why I made that reference. What? What is that? Is everyone else not seeing this? Huh? I feel so tired. Everything's just a huge pain. Why does everything seem so pointless? Is this some kind of mirage attack? But I've never seen anything like this. You won't escape. I said, you won't escape. What? You? Out of my way. I sense an immense amount of performer within her. Avoid killing her if you can. I want her alive. Hold it! I thought I said, get out of my way! Itsuki! Toma! Huh? Aya?
Tsubasa!
Tsubasa! Kiria! What do you think you're doing? We're in the middle of a battlefield. No. Kiria, because of me, she... My head. I must continue my mission and return to the idolosphere. Wait. Ayaha, wait! Kiria! I'm sorry. It's all my fault. I'm so sorry. Dang it. She's hurt pretty bad. This doesn't look good. We need to fall back and regroup. You have to go after her. Something is about to happen here. If we stop now, who knows what could happen to Shibuya or the world. But how are we supposed to fight against that many enemies? I can't fight my sister. Stop making excuses. You tell her, Kiria. Gasp! Except without the actual spelling. For 5 years, you were looking for her, right? But you didn't have any clues and no power to save her. But now, you do. So you have to go after her, no matter what. You're all Mirage Masters now. Like it or not, you're already involved in this. So, there's no point in just running from your fate when it's giving you a chance like this. Kiria. Say hi to Ayaha for me, alright? Tell her to hurry up and come back. Kiria! Don't worry, I'll take care of her. The rest is up to you. Be careful, everyone. Don't worry, Miss Maiko. We got this. This looks like the perfect time for a heroic comeback. We're the only ones that can do this. It's alright, Tsubasa. We've got your back. Okay. Let's go. Tsubasa Oribe's casual clothes have been added to the costume, Spring Flower. So now we have more costumes to use in battle. And, before we actually go, we need to go to the accessory shop because I would kind of like to boost some stats first. And yes, they're even affected inside buildings too. Welcome to Jewelry Krabia. Yep, alright, explained that before, so how can I assist? Let's see what they have in stock, because I can't remember. Because I know that Toma really doesn't need anything, but everyone else, kinda. Ooh, I forgot it costs this much. No, maybe let's not do anything for now. Let's just go into the dungeon until we can get some more money, and then we'll come back. Honestly, did forget that it cost that much. I thought it was honestly a few thousand less. Let's talk to Tsubasa. I need to save my sister as soon as possible. Please, Izuki, you have to help me. I don't know why I added that you have to when it just said help me. Now let's enter the 106 building. Yes, I want to go inside. Thing is that in Japan, in Shibuya, it's actually called the 109 building, not 106, but they just changed it because of... Can't really use real life locations. Well, they can use city names, but not actual building names, if you get what I'm saying. This isn't a dollhouse. It was a blue boo. Blue Caspar. So this is... Aya, where are you? Itsuki, make sure you keep an eye on Tsubasa. Got it. Krom, I need your strength again. And you will have it. Alright, Kane, let's get this show on the road. Well said. Let's storm the fear with speed beyond speed. So where's it gonna go, like, Mach 20 like Kuro Sensei, or what, I don't know. And that pretty much just explains that whenever we go deeper into the dungeon, we run into something similar to this, we can transport to another spot. And again, we have one of these we still can't use. Let's see. Let's go ahead and take him out. Pretty sure we're gonna have new enemies to go over, so this might be a while. Let's see who we got. Oh my. Here, I didn't think that we'd already run into him this early. So first we have a new enemy, Nickelwise. It is weak to swords, axes, ice, spirit, and body. Resistant to fire, and standard damage is done to it by lances, bows, electric, and force. Its average level is 6, and it's part of the beast class. Just when you thought clowns couldn't get any creepier, this one is a floating head with monstrous teeth. Talk about nightmare fuel. Strength is its best stat, and it knows two moves, attack and windbite. Windbite is actually a light physical session attack, yes. It is true that enemies can initiate session attacks too. It's triggered when a force attack is super effective against an ally. So yeah, when enemies have that, it can be a bit troublesome. Not very good. Let's just go ahead and attack here, because that thing's gonna be a problem. Special performance is, empty wave. We really don't want to use this unless we actually have to. But since we really have nothing else going on, I'm just gonna go ahead and show it. We'll take out Nickelwise with it. That's one enemy down. Okay, yeah, no good. I think we'll just use lances on it with skewer. Take it out fast. Go ahead and use Zio on this one. Take that, Boo ripoff. And they just had to do that, didn't they? There we go. 2 level ups. And Kronga, a new skill. Well, technically he did. Basically, you can boost the power of Zio now. And yes, that is okay. So, off to wherever we're going, because I'm honestly not sure where we're going next. Yeah, I already explained that before. We have a contact. Oh boy. Why am I just walking around? Let's go right here. Because enemies can't actually attack us, and I can check everything that's going on in contacts. Okay, apparently Tsubasa can now learn like a new unity. Oh. Actually have something for the main story. I have a message from Kiria. You have to chase after Ayaha, Oribe. She's in the idolosphere. Maiko took Kiria to the hospital. You don't need to worry. That was a message from Maiko. Yeah, I don't know if I'll actually show that since it didn't show up as a topic, even though it is part of the main story, but we'll see. So let's go on through here. Yes, let's go in. It's basically how you transport in this dungeon. See what you got to say. Aw, oh, gosh heck and dang, I can't get upstairs anymore. What am I gonna do now? I don't think he means any harm. Maybe I should try talking to him. Does someone come this way? I don't know. Maybe I can find something now if I get back upstairs. But I don't know how to get upstairs anymore. Who knew that you would actually find a PG spirit, or a G really, because he said, gosh heck and darn. But then again, that's stuff that I always say, so I'm okay with that. Let's see if we have any new enemies or not. Oh! Yeah, we do. Well then. Here we have the Ironclad Myrmidon. It is weak to lances and electric, spirit, and body. It is resistant to axes, ice, and standard damage is done to it by swords, bows, fire, and force. Its average level is 7 and is obviously part of the Myrmidon class. Its stats are pretty much equal with the exception of resistance and magic being low. It has 3 moves: Wind Strike, which is a light force attack, Cleave, and Fire Slash, which is another session skill when a fire skill is super effective against an ally. So, since we have him, go ahead and... Well, actually, I think we're just going to take out one of the cast bars first. Just to make it simple, even though the Ironclad Myrmidon is hitting next. Oh, I wasn't thinking of that. Crap. Yeah, we better go ahead and try to take him out real fast. Okay, tell me your turn. Let's use the poison skewer. I want to try to poison him. Yep, he's poisoned. I think. Yep, poisoned. And... I could take him out now, or I could take him. No, I'm just gonna take him out. There we go. And a critical! Can you keep pretending to shoot? Yeah, I think I'm gonna go ahead and heal Tsubasa. She's getting like halfway. Okay. Can't really use that because he's resistant. So might as well just use a regular attack. And now move to electric. And, well, almost got a new skill. Oh well. But we did get a stage rank up. New Awakening. And anytime you get a stage rank up, you always get a new performer. And this one, he has Leader's Gaze. And that kind of just explains what I already said. Oh, and Tsubasa got the same thing, but she has got Comforts of Home. So, before we actually switch the direction that this dress goes, there was a part of the previous area that I didn't really show off, so let's go there. Because there is an item. Don't know why I missed that. Let's see if there's a new enemy or not. Probably not, so I'll probably skip it. Actually no, let's not skip it, because I just want to like show a bit more of the battle system, so I really just skipped over it most of the time. In the last episode... Oh, not last episode, but the first two episodes. The second episode. Kinda confused why I even did in the previous episodes, but oh well. I'm gonna go ahead and take out this Myrmidon. Getting pretty close to death, and yeah, it's a good thing that Toma is resistant to fire, because the I don't know why, but the Kasparos keep trying to target him, and it's weird. He's gonna take out the Myrmidon. Thank you, Isuki. Overkill. Yeah, let's go ahead and take out the other ones. Just standard damage, but still helps take him out. And let Toma get the last hit. I know, like his Toma's victory pose kind of reminds me of Roy's in Smash. For his one taunt, anyways. Sword Blaze. We have got a session skill. Basically, any time that an enemy is weak to sword attacks and. For instance, like if Itsuki uses it, then that skill will activate. Yeah, time to go over. Through the dress, through the chest. Not meant to be inappropriate. Okay, let's change the direction of the dress. And here we want to use the right switch. So we use the other ones, then we won't be able to move anywhere. Of the dress, past the neck, and you know what? I think this is actually a really good stopping point, because we just started going through the dungeon, just showing off a few enemies, and it's already getting close to 30 minutes for the recording. So, next time on TMS Sharp FE, we'll be exploring the rest of Mirage 106 building of the idolosphere. And trying to find Ayaha, if we can actually get to her next episode, which we probably can't. We might spend, like, after this episode, like, two or three more episodes in here, because there are some cutscenes that can sometimes be a bit long, and we have to exit every now and then for different events. So, until next time, God bless, and I'll see you guys next time. Later, everyone.